first guest tonight says the president is sorely mistaken if he believes he can amend the U.S. Constitution by executive order. Joining us tonight, Congressman Trey Gowdy, a member of both the House Oversight and Judiciary Committees, also recently named chairman of the key subcommittee on immigration. Congressman, good to have you with us. Let's turn to first, if we may, to the idea that this president, if necessary, as his vice president has suggested, will, by executive order, constrain gun owner rights.
Lou, I can give you a long list of things to worry about in life, but this president, this vice president shredding our Second Amendment because they think it's politically expedient is not going to be one of them. You know, keep in mind, this president once taught the Constitution. I find it shocking how little regard he seems to have for that document. He may not like the Second Amendment. He can take that up with Madison and Jefferson and the fellas that framed it. But he is not going to run roughshod over the Second Amendment so he can curry favor with some political group or Hollywood. If he wants to have a discussion about how to stop mass killings, I am thrilled to have that conversation with him. But if he just wants to curry political points by running roughshod over the Second Amendment, that's not going to happen.
And the National Rifle Association meeting with the vice president and his task force today saying, that they, since there was far less a concern for the safety of our school children than there was a concern about continuing that assault on the Second Amendment. What's your reaction?
Well, Lou, I met with our sheriff today. I introduced our new Senator Tim Scott to our sheriff. And in Spartanburg, our sheriff and our school districts have decided to have armed law enforcement officers in our schools. That's a state and local decision. But Lou, the reality is we have gun control in this country. There are limits on who can possess the gun, there are limits on where they can possess the gun, and there are limits on what types of guns they can possess. If the president and the attorney general want to have a conversation about one aspect of federal law that's not being enforced, which is that dangerously mental ill people cannot possess any kind of firearm, even a pellet gun, much less an AR-15. If they want to have a conversation about how we can better enforce that, I'm happy to help them. But we don't need a federalized police presence at our local schools, and we're not going to shred the Second Amendment any more than I would expect him to shred the First Amendment. Have you heard one word about violent video games, violent videos, violent movies? Have you heard one word about shredding the Fourth Amendment if we're pretty sure that there's evidence in the apartment of a suspected mass killer? Have you heard one word about shredding the Fifth Amendment if we don't want to Mirandize a suspected mass killer, or the Sixth Amendment that we're not going to give the right to counsel to a suspected mass killer? No, they want to pick on the bastard child of the Bill of Rights, which is the Second Amendment, and it's not going to happen, not on my watch.
All right. Well, with that reassurance, Congressman, let me turn to Jack Lew and his nomination to replace Timothy Geithner as Treasury Secretary. Meeting, I think many people would say, unexpected opposition and energetic opposition from some Republicans in Washington, because he did preside as budget director over three balanced budgets, the last in our government to have done so under President Clinton. And he does come from Wall Street, obviously a capitalist.
Well, I would think after Chuck Hagel and Mr. Brennan that Senate Republicans would be tired. They have been opposing the names that have been thrown out for several days. I was actually with Senator Graham yesterday and, of course, Senator Scott today. I would say this with respect to Jack Lew. I am much more concerned by the fact that he presided over a budget proposal from this president, not President Clinton. I mean, my friends on the other side of the aisle love to go back to President Clinton. Well, let's just talk about this president. You know how many votes his budget proposal got in the United States House and the United States Senate? The same number of votes my daughter's budget proposal got. Zero. So I am more concerned over the fact that Jack Lew can't draft a budget that can even get Bernie Sanders or any of my more progressive House Democrats to vote for it. If he's willing to unveil the most closely guarded national secret we have, which is President Obama's deficit reduction plan, then I'll give him a fair hearing. If he's willing to encourage Harry Reid to do something as unbelievably revolutionary as pass a budget, then I'll be happy to give him a listen. But you know, Senator Graham and Senator Scott have both reminded me I'm in the House and I don't have a vote on confirmation, so I'll let them sort that out. But I'm more troubled about Mr. Liu's inability to propose a budget that can even garner a single solitary vote on Capitol Hill.
Senator Scott already reminding you of his new seat across the way there on Capitol Hill.
It didn't take long. It didn't take long.
Congressman, we appreciate you being here. Congressman Trey Gowdy.
Thank you.